We're going to create this bubble chart in Excel, and I will show you how to make it look professionally like this. A bubble chart visualizes data in three dimensions. The X and Y axis are coordinates, and a third variable determines the bubble size. It's great for highlighting extra context, since larger values create bigger bubbles. In bubble charts, the setup is crucial. Your data should be arranged in columns, from left to right. First, for the x-axis, revenue in our case, then the y-axis, the profit margin, and lastly, for the bubble size, the number of customers per region in our case. Labeling your data helps make it clear which values correspond to each axis and the bubble size. Another key point that often trips people up is to select only the data points. Don't include column or row headings. Go to Insert and choose the regular bubble chart, not the 3D. You can reposition the chart below your data and resize it by dragging its corners or sides. However, this may accidentally skew the data. To avoid that, it's best to double-click the chart to open the chart formatting menu on the side panel. Then select Lock Aspect Ratio under the Size and Properties menu to resize it proportionally. Right now, it's hard to tell what the graph represents. We need to label everything. Again, double-click the chart to open the chart formatting menu on the side panel. There are several options here depending on what you select on your chart. The first two appear for all elements. The first one is the fill-in line, which formats the selected element. The second are effects, adding effects to your element, which I use the least. The third and fourth options appear depending on the chart selection. The size and properties control size and properties for the selected element. And the options is available for elements like axes and labels. To format any of the elements, I need to first select it. For the x-axis, the revenue, I can set a minimum starting point. If you see negative numbers that don't make sense, make sure zero is the minimum. To remove empty space, I will set the maximum revenue to 550,000 instead of the 600,000. If your data has many zeros, you can add units to clean it up. You can reposition the labels at the bottom or top of your chart. I will keep it at the bottom. Currently, my revenue numbers use custom formatting. I can change it to currency, percentage, or regular numbers, and adjust the decimal places shown. I will remove the units and the decimal places, as in the case of the revenue here, it doesn't make sense. For my y-axis, the profit margin, I will add one decimal point. To add elements, go to Add Chart Elements in the upper left menu. But before I do, I will select the entire chart and select the font for all my elements. I will add a primary horizontal axis for revenue and format it. I will also add a vertical axis label for profit margin and format it the same way. Next, I will add a chart title, Revenue versus Profit Margin by Region. This helps clarify what the data represents, though it's still unclear which bubble represents which region. To adjust bubble size, select them and go to the series options. The size is based on the area at 100. I will test it at 150, but that's too much. So I will settle at 125, which provides good chart coverage without too much white space. Currently, my bubbles don't show enough information because the bubble label element is missing. To fix this, go to Add Chart Element and select Data Labels. Then choose their position. I will use center for now. Right now, the bubbles display profit margin, which doesn't make sense. I need them to show bubble size, the number of customers. Select the label and under label options, switch to bubble size. To add region names, select value from cells and select the region names range. You can also select the separator between the two different data points. I will format the labels for better visibility and test different positions. I also want to change the bubble colors. To change one, single select it twice, then change its color under fill and line. If you want to change all the colors at once, select fill and line and choose vary color by point. Excel assigns random colors, but for a professional look, I like to create a color palette. I will color code bubbles by size using a darker or lighter shade based on data value. To emphasize specific region, I can use distinct colors. Some labels might not be visible. I will adjust their color, dark text on lighter bubbles and light text on darker ones, and resize the labels to match the bubble size. Finally, I will format the bubble label text into two lines and manually reposition them. This is helpful when bubbles are close together. To make the chart clearer, I will add details to the title to explain what the bubble size represent. And there you have it, our final bubble chart. It looks much better than with what we started. Thanks so much for watching.